Hey guys, I'm Maddie, and I know that it caused me a lot of stress and anxiety not knowing what would happen if I failed step one. So now that I actually have failed step one, I just kind of wanted to give you guys my experience on what my options were, and maybe that'll help ease your anxiety while you're awaiting your test scores or if you just found out that you failed. So let's get into it. So just a disclaimer, these are my experiences and are likely just specific to my school. The only thing that I was honestly able to find online when I was doing research was just some stuff on Reddit, and it wasn't even super clear what the options were, and people were kind of all over the place. So again, these are just my experiences, but hopefully they will help relieve some stress for you guys. So I found out I failed on a Wednesday afternoon. I got back into town on Thursday evening, and then I had a meeting with my dean via Zoom on Friday. So your school finds out at the same time that you do, if not beforehand. I'm not really sure what the consensus is on that, but your school does find out about the same time that you do, what your score is, whether you do pass or fail, etc. So during my meeting with this dean, she basically gave me three options. Option number one was I had 5 weeks to post a passing score. So I guess I should probably rewind a little bit. I took my step exam on the last possible day for my school. So then I had 2 weeks after that day until we started rotations. So I actually got my test scores back within those 2 weeks, which was super quick, but it could have even, I could have even gotten them back after rotations had started. So if you take your exam before the deadline, basically, you may have a little bit more time than that, but our rotations are 5 or 10 weeks long. So essentially what they gave me was the first 5 week rotation would have been dedicated to restudying for step again and taking that exam. The catch was that I had to post a passing score by the end of those 5 weeks. So that means that I had to allot 2 weeks to get the score back. So I essentially, like, 2 to 3 weeks. They were pushing more towards 3 weeks, but they're like, it's up to you, but if you don't post that passing score, you're gonna have to take another year, like that whole year off. So essentially I had 18 days to study for step again if I chose that option. And that would have been probably the most ideal option, because I could have been able to continue through, just pick back up with rotations and continue on like nothing had happened. I think that that 5 weeks essentially would have been my elective rotation. So that probably would have worked out pretty seamlessly. So the next option is actually taking the entire year off. And that is pretty, like, I feel like the most flexible option. That's the one that I chose to do, just because 18 days seemed like a pretty short period of time, especially after just having studied for step for 3 months. I really didn't want to jump right back into it, so it was kind of like a choose your own adventure type thing. You can take as much time as you needed and just take the year off, and then you just pick up rotations with the following class. And so then you can like take that year, volunteer, do research, really better your application overall, which is really a fantastic option. My school, just kind of going off this a little bit, my school wanted to give me the month of, so it was like, I found out I failed like the end of April, and then they basically wanted me to take the month of May to just rest, chill, hang out, and then starting the first week of June, hit the ground running studying, and they had like formulated a whole program for me to start studying again. I think that's pretty much all that I need to say about that one. And then the third option was honestly kind of strange, and when I was talking to the dean about it, she was very vague with this option, but I'm not sure if other schools have similar options, but basically, it was like you could take as much time within the next year off. So like say you wanted to take more than like say you didn't want to hit the ground running studying again, and you wanted to like take the month off, start studying, post a passing score, and then jump right into rotations. So that's basically your option. However, you couldn't, like, you were still gonna graduate a year later. So you would basically take 2 years to do your third year rotations, which I thought was kind of strange, and I'm not really sure why that would be like an advantageous option. But basically, so like for example, say me right now, like I didn't want to start studying, and then I start studying in June, study from June to August, and then in September I want to pick up my rotations again that I would have been on already. So then I can continue on with those rotations and go through them. And then the following year, the rotations that I hadn't done yet, I would do those. And then I guess you would have free time later on. So maybe like if you knew that you had something going on that would have been during your fourth year, then it wouldn't affect that per se, and you could get a lot of your rotations out of the way and then make that kind of weird middle year a little bit easier. You could probably do research and whatnot. So I'm not really sure. Maybe that would be a better option for somebody who was already planning on taking a year off, but I still don't know why that would be better than just taking the year off anyways. So that is what I experienced. I know that other schools are different. I know other schools maybe give you a little bit more time. And like I said at the beginning of the video, I was crunched, so my options were a little bit more limited. I think that if I had taken the exam maybe like 3 weeks sooner, then I would have had, I guess, 8 weeks to study, because I could have either A, it wouldn't have been a problem because I could have retaken it before rotations had even started if I'd taken it way sooner. Or, which probably isn't the best choice, or I could have just taken those extra weeks plus that first 5 weeks of rotations and used all that and then just continued on. So those are my options. If you guys like this video, please give it a like and subscribe because it really supports our channel, and I'll see you next time. Thanks.